This is the City of West Melbourne's Sylvan Drive Septic to Sewer Project. What we're doing here is there are 59 homes in this neighborhood that are on septic systems currently, most of them built in the 70s or early 80s, and we are converting them over and tying them to a new sewer system that's being built in the neighborhood. Septic tanks, while they're good in the right locations, the right siting, the right design and operation, they will leach nutrients, nitrogen, phosphorus, as well as some other coliforms into the ground, which if it's located near a surface water, can leach into that surface water. And right now it's estimated about 1,070 pounds per year of nitrogen are flowing to the lagoon from this neighborhood. A sewer system, those plumbing drains, instead of being connected to a septic tank, are instead connected to a pipe that leads to the street, connects to a gravity sewer, and from there it goes usually to a lift station and ultimately to the city's wastewater treatment plant, where it can then be treated and either used as irrigation or some several other beneficial uses. They're very challenging projects to convert an existing neighborhood from septic systems to sewer. If we were building this neighborhood from scratch, first thing that we would do is build the gravity sewer system, because it's the deepest utility that gets put into these roadways and into development. And since it's so deep, it requires major excavation, as you can see, requires things like dewatering. All of those are big challenges to do when you're in an existing built development. Now we're in a road that we need to keep traffic open to. We have to work around all the other utilities that would be normally put in after the sanitary sewer is in. So it is really one of the most challenging jobs we do. This is just one of many septic to sewer conversion projects that'll take place in Brevard County. One of the biggest challenges of tackling the really hard infrastructure problem that we have is we need cooperation of many different entities. And this project is a great example. This project would not happen without the Save Our Indian River Lagoon funding, but it also required funding from the St. John's River Water Management District and the leadership and funding from the City of West Melbourne to champion the project. And all of those entities have come together to make this possible. One of the things we all love about everyone who lives here, we love the lagoon, we love being by the water, it's why we all chose to live here. Anything that we can do to improve the water quality of that lagoon, not just for now, but for future generations, my children and their children, it's why we do these things. It's why we are in these professions.